For written notes of this topic, you can find their link in the description below. The natural topography, including drainage. Topography. It is the study of surface features of the land. Pakistan can be categorized into six topographical areas. These six topographical areas include Northern and Northwestern Mountains, Western Mountains, Potwar Plateau and Salt Ranges, Balochistan Plateau, Indus Plain, and Desert Areas. Northern and Northwestern Mountains. Relief. It includes Karakoram, Himalaya, and the Hindu Kush. These ranges run from west to east. Its height changes from 6,000 meter to 8,475 meter, south to the north respectively. It has deep narrow valleys, namely Kagan, Baltistan, and Chitral. It also has snow-capped, sharp, and steep-sided peaks like Nanga Parbat, Tirich Mir, and K2. It has Siachen, Baltoro, and Bathura that are huge glaciers or snowfields. It has high passes including Khunjera, Chandur, and Lavarai. Drainage. Eastern tributaries include Jhelum, Chenab, River Indus, Ravi, Bias, and Satluj. Western tributaries include Kabul and Sawat. Economy and people. In summers, when the snow peaks melt, the water drains into River Indus and its tributaries. This drainage helps in the irrigation of Indus Plain. These mountains are a source of valuable minerals, fruits, and timber. They are historic passes that connect Pakistan to Afghanistan and China. There is also a natural border between CAS Republic and China. The mountains protect against the cold winds from CAS, making the climate bearable. The beautiful scenery attracts tourists and promotes the resort business in Gilgit, Hunza, Mari, Naran, etc. These mountains also provide raw material for chemicals, furniture, paper, etc. Western Mountains. Relief. Kirthar, Safedko, Waziristan, and Suleiman are the parallel ranges that run from south to north. The height expands from 2000 meters to 4712 meters, south to the north respectively. There are several valleys and low-lying basins including Banu Valley, Kohat Valley, and the Valley of Peshawar. The peaks there are not very big in height. Safedko is the only peak that is covered in snow. There are many historic passes including Bolan, Gomal, Khyber, Tochi, and Khurram. There are not many glaciers. Drainage. The drainages include Khurram, Hub, Liari, Tochi, Zop, and Gomal. Economy and people. The water drains in the western rivers and helps in the cultivation of sugarcane, rice, and wheat. The passes connect Pakistan to Afghanistan. The passes also connect Karachi to Sipi. These mountains create a defensive wall between Pakistan and Afghanistan. These mountains are rich in boulders, clay, limestones, ridges, and sandstones. These mountains prevent Pakistan from western depressions. They are important military centers, namely Kohat and Banu. Potwar Plateau. Relief. It is an open plateau with undulating land and an extensive flat area. Its height varies from 300 meters to 600 meters. It has residual hills. It has a bedland topography, that is troughs, ravines, and landscape of ridges. It has parallel salt ranges from 750 meters to 900 meters. Drainage. The drainage includes River Son, Uchali, Khabeki, and Kallar Kahar. Economy and people. It is rich in soapstones, marble, non-metallic minerals, limestone, gypsum, dolomite, and clay. It has oil and gas fields, namely Attock Oil Refinery. on Potwar Plateau through rainwater, gram, wheat, barley, and maize are cultivated.
Balochistan Plateau.
Relief. It has ridges and eroded landscape. It has barren mountain ranges, including Toba Kakar, Hala, Rusko, and Makran Coast, from 600 meters to 3010 meters. There are several irregular depressions, including Loralai and Zob Basin. On the western side, there are inland drainage basins. There is a Lasbela Plain that is marked by sand dunes and gravel. It has Makran Coast with a narrow coastal plain. Drainage. The drainages include Hingol, Dasht, Hub, and Paroli. There are also temporary salt lakes, namely Hamune Lora and Hamune Mashkal. Economy and people. In Kharan and Panjgor, there are gold and antimony deposits. There are also gas, crude oil, and coal deposits. The economy is through livestock and its products and fishing at Ormara, Gawadar, and Pasni. There is also a vegetable seed industry. Balochistan's economic potential. There are gold and antimony reserves. By using the untapped resources of Balochistan, Pakistan's economy can see an uplift. Using the crude oil, coal, and natural gas present in Balochistan, electricity can be generated. Many fruits grow in Balochistan, including melons, peaches, grapes, apples, dates, pomegranate, peaches, and plums. The economy can be boosted by exporting these fruits to Gulf countries. Since Balochistan's climate is favorable, more vegetable seeds should be grown there. The economy can also be improved by increasing the livestock and its products using scientific means, because wool and goat skins have high demand in the global market. Moreover, the export of fish can also be increased by using modern technology at Gawadar, Ormara, and Pasni for fishing. The Gawadar seaport development can also help in the development of the economy. Shortcoming. The weather in Balochistan is extreme and dry, making the working condition unfavorable. Balochistan has the lowest population density. There are not enough skilled individuals and the workforce. The province has a shortage of water, making it difficult to provide proper irrigation. The infrastructure is bad and there are fewer link roads, limiting the travel and trade. The people there are not very educated. The landscape is eroded with rugged terrain and ridges, making it impossible to complete projects on time. Dopes. A dope can be found at the confluence of the two rivers, that is a land. There is Sindh Sagar Dope between the river Jhelum and river Sindh. Chaj Dope between river Chenab and Jhelum. Rachna Dope between river Ravi and Chenab. Bari Dope between river Satluj and Ravi. Importance of dopes. The terrain is flat there. The canal water promotes and supports agriculture. Urban settlement can be done without hassle. There are links to air, rail, and road development. Factories and industrial estates are established. Moreover, businesses, markets, and storage of raw materials of agriculture are provided. Topographical features of the Indus Plain. Active flood plains. Bat or Khattar is a narrow strip of land on both sides of the river. It is flooded almost every year. When the season of rain concludes, alluvium can be found in its dry and braided channels. Old flood plains. It is the area between the terraces of alluvial and active flood plain. When there is heavy rainfall, only then it is flooded. Oxbows, abundant channels, and meander scars can be found on these plains. Alluvial terraces. These are areas of high grounds. They are formed by old alluvium erosion. They are also known as scalloped interfluves. They can be found in Bari, Rachna, Chajtop and the Upper Indus Plain. The alluvial terraces are ideal for agriculture.
Piedmont Plains.
They are formed in the rainy season when streams and rivers deposit alluvium at the foot of the mountain. They support agriculture too. They are also known as Derajat. These rivers deposit alluvium, sand and gravel. These can be found at Himalayan mountain Kirthar and Suleiman. Tidal Delta. It is located in the south of Thatta. It is triangular fan-shaped. The distributaries branch out from it like ribs. It has mangrove swamps and tidal flats. The land is frequently exposed to seawater. The land is mostly covered in swamps, limiting agriculture. Poor infrastructure results in less industrial and commercial activities. The undeveloped road makes it difficult to transport heavy vehicles. The frequent tropical cyclones damages shanty homes, agriculture and fishing. These features of the Indus Delta have resulted in a low-density population. Rolling sand plains. They are usually found in desert areas because sand dunes are a feature of deserts. In deserts, the wind blows and changes landscape frequently, which result in sand dunes. Kustas. These can be found in the lower Indus Plains. In Sindh, these are limestone-made ridges. The ridges support the construction of barrages and irrigation. Deserts of Pakistan. There are three desert areas in Pakistan. Between River Jhelum and River Indus, there is the Thal Desert, which is also known as Sindh Sagar Doab. In the southeastern part of Pakistan, there is the Thar Desert. This desert can further categorize into Tharpakkar, Nara and the Cholistan. The Kharan Desert can be located in the western Balochistan. Features of the desert. There is water scarcity because of low rainfall. There are fast blowing winds that frequently changes the desert. Rolling stone dunes, lack of vegetation and rocks are other main features. If you like this video, don't forget to like us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram and LinkedIn, and subscribe to our YouTube channel.